गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर 3 फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 5 इंडिगो, रिटन बाय लुई फिशर फॉर क्लास 12th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, बुक फ्लेमिंगो। चिल्ड्रन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू 2 लेक्चर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर नंबर 3 आई विल बी टेकिंग फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 52 to 54 and today we will be completing the whole chapter. Before I proceed further with lecture number 3, I must recapitulate lecture number 1 and 2 for your convenience. So let us begin this lecture with the recapitulation of lecture number 1. Let us recapitulate. I taught you in lecture number 1 that Louis Fisher met Gandhiji in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram. Gandhiji told him that how he initiated the departure of the British from India. He recalled it in 1917 at the request of Rajkumar Shukla, a sharecropper from Champaran. He visited the place. Gandhi had gone to Lucknow to attend the annual meeting of Indian National Congress in the year 1916. And Shukla told him that he had come from Champaran to seek his help in order to safeguard the interests of the sharecroppers. Gandhi told him that he was busy, so Shukla accompanied Gandhiji to various places till he consented to visit Champaran. His firm decision impressed Gandhiji and he promised him that he would definitely visit Calcutta at a particular date and then Shukla could come and take him along to Champaran. Shukla met him at Calcutta and they took a train to Patna. Gandhiji went to lawyer Rajendra Prasad and he could not find him there. In order to grab complete knowledge of the situation, he wanted to see him. As he could not find him, so he decided to go to Muzaffarpur and he reached there on April 15, 1917. He was welcomed by Professor J.B. Kriplani and his students at the station. Gandhiji was surprised to see the immense support for an advocate of home rule like him. He also met some lawyers who were already handling cases of sharecroppers. As per the contract, 15% of the peasants' land holding was to be reserved for cultivation of indigo, the crop of which was given to the landlord as rent. This system was very oppressive. Gandhi wanted to help the sharecroppers now. Now we will recapitulate lecture number 2, in which I taught you the cancellation of 15% arrangement or the agreement between the British and the poor peasants of Champaran. Then we covered Gandhi's arrival at Champaran. Then Gandhiji would not obey the order that he declared. Then the attempt of setting themselves free from the fear of the British. Then the crowd in front of law court was uncontrollable. Then it was Gandhiji's duty towards humanity that he controlled the crowd there and helped the people, officials. Then Gandhiji remained free without any bail. Then Gandhiji advised the lawyers also about helping those poor peasants. And then Gandhi's peaceful protest had won. So what I taught you in this lecture number 2, that Gandhiji visited the British Landlord Association, but he was not given any information because he was considered an outsider. He then went to the commissioner of Tirhut division, who threatened Gandhi and asked him to leave Tirhut. Instead of returning, he went to Motihari. Here he started gathering complete information about the indigo contract and he was accompanied by many lawyers. Then one day, as he was on his way to meet a peasant who was maltreated by the indigo planters, he was stopped by a police superintendent's messenger who served him a notice asking him to leave. Gandhi received the notice but disobeyed the order. A case was filed against him. Many lawyers came to advise him, but when he stressed, they all joined his struggle and even consented to go to jail in order to help the poor peasants. On the day of trial, a large crowd gathered near the court and it became impossible to handle them. Gandhiji helped the officials to control the crowd. Gandhi gave the statement that he was not a lawbreaker, but he disobeyed so that he could help those poor peasants. He was granted bail and later on, the case against him was dropped. Gandhi and his associates started gathering all sorts of information related to Indigo contract and its misuse. Then Gandhiji had to seek the advice of other lawyers also. He motivated those lawyers to support the poor peasants. And then Gandhiji started his peaceful protest against the injustice that was tolerated or imposed on those poor farmers. So children, now let's proceed with page number 52, in which we shall talk about the commission that was formed to inquire the complete case of sharecroppers. And children, the first para begins with the last two lines given on page number 51 in your book. So I am starting from there. In June, Gandhi was summoned to Sir Edward Gate, the Lieutenant Governor. Before he went, he met leading associates and again laid detailed plans for civil disobedience if he should not return. Gandhi had four protracted interviews with the Lieutenant Governor, as a result appointed an official commission of inquiry into the Indigo sharecroppers' situation. The commission consisted of landlords, government officials, and Gandhi as the sole representative of the peasants. Children, in the first line it is written, summoned. Summoned means called, right? So what does the writer write here? He says in June, Gandhi was called up to be present before Deputy Governor Sir Edward Gate. Before meeting him, he met his chief supporters and made plans for civil disobedience in case he did not return. Gandhi had four long interviews, right? He had four long interviews with the deputy commissioner, which led to the information of a commission that inquired into the Indigo sharecroppers' situation. The commission included landlords, government officials, and Gandhi, who was the only spokesperson for the peasants. Now let's proceed with para number 2 on page number 52. Gandhi remained in Champaran for an initial uninterrupted period of 7 months. Initial means at the start, and uninterrupted means continuous. So Gandhi remained in Champaran for continuous or in the beginning for continuous period of 7 months and then again for several shorter visits. The visit undertaken casually on the entreaty. Entreaty means request. On the humble request of an unlettered peasant in the expectation that it would last a few days, occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. And who was that unlettered peasant? That was Rajkumar Shukla, who brought Gandhiji to solve this matter of sharecroppers in Champaran. The official inquiry assembled a crushing mountain of evidence against the big planters, and when they saw this, they agreed in principle to make refunds to these peasants. But how much must we pay? They asked Gandhi. Now, Gandhi remained in Champaran for 7 months. He also made several short visits later, and his visit on the request of a peasant was presumed to last a few days, but it took at least a year of his life, and the official inquiry did not favor the planters. Hence, they agreed to pay back to the peasants. But they questioned Gandhi regarding the amount to be repaid to those poor peasants. Now, we shall proceed further, in which we will read about Gandhi won the honor for peasants. See on page number 52, second last paragraph. They thought he would demand repayment in full of the money which they had illegally and deceitfully extorted from the sharecroppers. Deceitfully means dishonestly. Extorted means took forcibly. Right? He asked only 50%. There he seemed adamant. Adamant means firm. Writes Reverend J.Z. Hodge, a British missionary in Champaran, who observed the entire episode at close range. Thinking probably that he would not give way, the representative of the planters offered to refund to the extent of 25%, and to his amazement, Mr. Gandhi took him at his word, thus breaking the deadlock. Deadlock means a situation in which no progress can be made. Right? Now, they thought, those moneylenders had thought that Gandhi would ask for the full repayment of the money which they had taken from those poor peasants forcefully. But Gandhiji asked only for 50% refund and his decision was firm. Then, a missionary, Reverend J.Z. Hodge, who had a close watch on the matter, reported this. Then, the planters offered to pay only 25% as they thought it would be rejected by Gandhi. Then the settlement was adopted unanimously. Unanimously means without opposition by the commission, and Gandhi explained that the amount of refund was less important than the fact that the landlords had been obliged to surrender part of the money and with it part of their prestige. Prestige means honor, esteem. Right? Therefore, as far as the peasants were concerned, the planters had behaved as lords above the law. Now, the peasants saw that he had rights and defenders. Defenders means protectors. And he learned courage. So what does he say in these lines? When Gandhiji demanded 50% and there he was firm, but the moneylenders said they would pay only 25% refund to those poor people. They offered to pay only 25%. Then Gandhiji did not have any objection. He did not reject it. He immediately accepted it. Gandhi said that the amount of money was not important, but by giving money, the planters had bowed down to the peasants and had given away their honor too. The planters who earlier behaved as if they were above the law now had to abide by it. This made the peasants realize their rights and give them courage to fight for them. And Gandhiji felt very happy along with other peasants that it was happening in the history of India the first time that the British landlords were surrendering in front of the poor peasants and they got agreed to pay at least 25% refund to those poor farmers. So Gandhiji thought that it was not important to pay the money, but it was more important that along with the money they were surrendering a part of their prestige the very first time in front of Indians. Children, there would be a very important question based on these lines, so please note it down. Now we shall read about Gandhi's thought of upgrading the villagers on page number 53, first para. Events justified Gandhi's position. Justified means marked by a good or legitimate reason. Events justified Gandhi's position. Within a few years, the British planters abandoned their estates. Abandoned means inhabited or deserted. They deserted their estates, which reverted to the peasants. Reverted means returned. And indigo sharecropping disappeared. Gandhi never contented himself. Contented means satisfied. Gandhi never satisfied himself with large political or economic solutions. He saw the cultural and social backwardness in the Champaran villages and wanted to do something about it immediately. He appealed means requested, for teachers. Mahadev Desai and Narhari Parekh, two young men who had just joined Gandhi as disciples. Disciples means pupils, students. and their wives volunteered for the work. Volunteered means free services. Several more came from Bombay, Pune and other distant parts of the land. Devdas, Gandhi's youngest son, arrived from the ashram and so did Mrs. Gandhi. Primary schools were opened in 6 villages. Kasturbai taught the ashram rules on personal cleanliness and community sanitation. So, children, events had proven Gandhiji's position there in Champaran, and the British planters had to leave their property within the next few years. These properties were returned back to the poor peasants, and indigo sharecropping soon came to an end. Then Gandhi was not satisfied by achieving political or economic solutions. He sought to remove the cultural and social backwardness of Champaran and its people. Gandhi wanted to do something to remove the backwardness of the village of Champaran. He requested teachers such as Mahadev Desai and Narhai Parekh and their wives to teach the villagers. Both of them were followers of Gandhi, pupils of Gandhi. So many other volunteers also came from Bombay and Pune to join them. Then Mrs. Gandhi and their youngest son Devdas also arrived from ashram for their help. Primary schools were opened in 6 villages where Kasturbai used to teach the ashram rules on cleanliness and community sanitation. Therefore, it was written in the beginning or the previous text that Gandhi stayed there for at least 1 year in order to resolve not only the sharecropping system or their matter with the British, but he started improving the condition of the villagers also, because he noticed that the condition of the villagers was pathetic. Their plight was really miserable. So he thought it is better to upgrade the standard of the villagers by teaching them the lesson on cleanliness and community sanitation. After working on the upgradation of their education, cleanliness and community sanitation, Gandhi started working for their health improvement. Health conditions were miserable. Gandhi got a doctor to volunteer his services for 6 months. 3 medicines were available. They were castor oil, quinine and sulfur ointment. Anybody who showed a coated tongue was given a dose of castor oil. Anybody with malaria fever received quinine plus castor oil. And anybody with skin eruptions means spot, rashes or other marks appearing suddenly on the skin, received the ointment plus castor oil. Castor was the name of a seed. So these were the 3 medicines available there, castor oil, quinine and sulfur ointment, and all the treatment was done of those patients with these 3 medicines only. Gandhi noticed the filthy state. Filthy means dirty. Dirty states of women's clothes. He asked Kasturbai to talk to them about it. One woman took Kasturbai into her hut and said, "Look, there is no box or cupboard here for clothes. The sari I am wearing is the only one I have." So children, what we read in these lines that the health conditions of the people of Champaran were very poor. It was miserable. So Gandhi got a doctor who offered his free services of castor for 6 months. There were only 3 medicines, castor oil, quinine and sulfur ointment available there. So a patient with coated tongue was given castor oil. Malaria patients were given a dose of quinine and a patient with a skin disorder was given ointment and castor oil, etc. The women of the area used to wear dirty clothes. So when Gandhi tried to know the reason through his wife, he was told that those were the only saris each of the women had. Now we shall proceed further with the last para given on page number 53, and then we'll read about the Britishers could not order Gandhi in his own country. During his long stay in Champaran, Gandhi kept a long distance watch on the ashram. He sent regular instructions by mail and asked for finance accounts. financial accounts. Once he wrote to the residents that it was time to fill in the old latrine trenches and dig new ones, otherwise the old ones would begin to smell bad. And the Champaran episode was a turning point in Gandhi's life. Children, you'll be asked to answer a long answer type question based on this line, that Champaran episode was a turning point in Gandhi's life. What I did, he explained, was a very ordinary thing. I declared that the British could not order me about in my country, in my own country. In these lines, when Gandhiji was in Champaran, he kept a long distance vigil on the ashram. He used to send letters of orders regarding financial matters. Once he wrote to the locals that it was the time to dig new latrines as the old ones had started giving foul smell. The Champaran incident changed Gandhi's life. He said that he had done a regular thing. He had put his point across that the Britishers could not order him in his own country. So he thought residents means locals living over there. So Gandhiji thought that in his own country he would not be ordered by any Britisher. This was a turning point. This Champaran episode actually gave inspiration to Gandhi that the battle of freedom from the British can also be won, as the battle of Champaran was won. Once he made the peasants free from the fear of the British, he was successful in winning the battle of Champaran. So this battle of Champaran, or staying there in Champaran, filled him with new energy. Now we shall continue with para number 2 on page number 54, in which we'll read about Gandhi's politics was for the people of India. Now see in your book, but Champaran did not begin as an act of defiance. Defiance means opposition. It grew out of an attempt to alleviate the distress of large number of poor peasants. Alleviate means uplift. This was the typical Gandhi pattern. His politics were intervened means connected with each other, with the practical day-to-day problems of the millions. He was not a loyalty to abstractions. Abstractions means something which exists only as an idea. It was a loyalty to living human beings. In everything Gandhi did, moreover, he tried to mold a new free Indian who could stand on his own feet and thus make India free. Children, the Champaran Satyagraha was not an act of opposition. It was an attempt to help out the poor and tortured peasants. This was Gandhi's way to solve issues. His politics was knitted up with everyday problems faced by the millions of people. He did not aim at a fulfillment of ideas, rather he was concerned for the people. The basic idea was to serve humanity and make a free Indian who could stand for his rights. Because Champaran episode taught him that once he makes Indians free from the fear of British, then it would not be tough to win the battle against them. Children, now we are proceeding towards the final ending of the chapter, in which we'll read about Gandhi's idea of being self-dependent, free and helping the poor. Now see in your book on page number 54, last paragraph. Early in the Champaran action, Charles Freer Andrews, the English pacifist means peacemaker, who had become a devoted follower of the Mahatma, came to bid Gandhi farewell before going on a tour of duty to the Fiji Islands. Gandhi's lawyer friends thought it would be a good idea for Andrews to stay in Champaran and help them. Andrews was willing if Gandhi agreed, but Gandhi was vehemently opposed. Vehemently means in an intense manner. Gandhi opposed this idea. He said, "You think that in this unequal fight it would be helpful if we have an Englishman on our side? This shows the weakness of your heart. The cause is just and you must rely upon yourself to win the battle. You should not seek a prop. Prop means support. You should not seek a prop means support in Mr. Andrews because he happens to be an Englishman. He had read our minds correctly, Rajendra Prasad comments. And we had no reply. Gandhi in this way taught us a lesson in self-reliance. Self-reliance, Indian independence and help to sharecroppers were all bound together. Children, in these lines the writer writes, Charles Prior Andrews, who was a peacemaker, visited Gandhi before going on a tour of duty to the Fiji Islands. Gandhi's lawyer friends wanted Andrew to stay at ashram and help them, but Gandhiji refused. He said that they did not need the help of the British as it showed a lack of trust in their own abilities. He asked them not to seek any help from Mr. Andrews as he was an Englishman. Rajendra Prasad later on stated that Gandhi had read their thoughts and his reply served as a lesson of self-sufficiency for them. Being self-dependent, free and helping the peasants, all these acts of Gandhi were interconnected. So children, here your chapter ends. Children, now we are proceeding towards homework. Your homework of the day is read the chapter Indigo thoroughly from page number 52 to 54. That is the ending of this chapter from your book Flamingo. And answer the questions given on page number 53 in your extra work English notebook. In my next lecture of this chapter, I'll be discussing all the textual questions given in your textbook with you. By the time, thank you. Have a nice day.